Okay, good morning students. Today we will discuss the three topics. So first one is hot wire anemometer. So and this is one type of transducer, and the second one is resistance thermometer, and the third one is LVDT, so linear variable displacement transducer. So first we will see this hot wire anemometer. The basic principle is, so whatever the flow is there, either it may be a water flow or gas flow, that flow will be passing through a heating coil. So that flow is converted into a change in resistance. So that means the change in resistance of a wire becomes a measure of flow rate. So whatever the flow we want to measure, so that is converted into a change in the resistance. So coming to the description, there are two types of operation. First one is constant current method, and the second one is temperature method. So if you see the constant current method, so gas is flowing through this coil. So what happens, suppose this coil is a hot wire. Gas is having a different temperature, so when it is passing through this hot wire, so that means this temperature, the hot wire temperature will decrease. So the temperature will come to the gas flow. So here the output of this out. The resistance. So before that, we will see the operation of Wheatstone bridge. So Wheatstone bridge is used to measure the unknown voltage. So here R1, R2, and R3. These three are known voltages, and R4 is unknown voltage. So here there is a galvanometer. So this will measure small amount of current. So when the current flowing through galvanometer is zero, so that position we call as a null position. So then we can say that this bridge is said to be balanced. So when this bridge is balanced, it will satisfy this condition, R1 by R4 equal to R2 by R3. So R1 by R4 equal to R2 by R3. So from here, R4 equal to what? R3 by R2. So that means if there is change in galvanometer, there will be a rheostat. So that means by for this bridge, we are giving a external supply back through the battery. So by adjusting this resistance, we can make this galvanometer reading as zero. So when galvanometer reading is zero, it will come onto the null position. So by varying this, this is rheostat. Rheostat means by varying the, so rheostat is used to vary the. So when galvanometer comes to zero, it will be in null position. So bridge is said to be balanced, so that we can find out the unknown resistance. So if you see, so that is the operation of the galvanometer. Coming to the operation, so constant current method. So what happens? There will be a change in the heat. So that means gas is having a separate temperature, and hot wire is having a separate temperature. So whatever the heat present in the this heat coil will come to the gas. So this gas flow will be so the flow of gas will be given to the R4 resistance. There will be a change in the galvanometer current. So here this resistance R1, R2, and R3. These three resistances are known resistance, but you have to find out the change in the resistance. That means R4 you have to find out. So that means if there is a change in the galvanometer, by adjusting the rheostat, by adjusting the resistance in the rheostat, we can make the galvanometer current as zero. So that means when the galvanometer current is zero, so what happens, it will come to null position. So that means when it is come to null position, it will satisfy that bridge is said to be balanced. so that by using this formula we can find out the unknown resistance. So this is one type of operation, that is constant current method. And next one is constant temperature method. So in constant temperature method, the temperature of hot wire, so here the temperature of hot wire, this is a hot wire, is kept constant. So when temperature is kept constant, there will be a flow of gas from this hot wire. So when it is a flow of gas through the hot wire, that means there will be current flowing through this hot wire. So due to this, there will be a change in the galvanometer. So by adjusting this rheostat, so you can make this bridge in null position. That means bridge is said to be balanced. So we can connect. So that means by using this one, you can find out the resistance to this arm by using this formula. And we can find out if we keep one voltmeter across this R4, it will measure the reading across the R4. So through this method, we can find out the resistance across this arm. Okay, this is a constant current method. So there are two types operation, operations: constant current method and constant temperature method. So here we make, we'll fix the current. So that is constant current. We will here the temperature of the coil is constant and the current may vary. So that means in hot wire anemometer, so what we are doing, we are converting whatever the gas flow into a change in the resistance. So that means gas flow is the physical quantity. So we are converting, that means it will convert into an electrical quantity. So that rate of change of heat is given to a resistor. So that is converted into resistor, rate of change of resistor. So that the resistance is calculated by using the Wheatstone bridge. So this is the principle of hot wire anemometer. This is the thermal method. So here in constant temperature method, change in the current will be give the rate of flow. So there will be some change in the current, so in the resistors R4, so that gives the rate of flow. So this is the diagram for the constant current method. Advantages, if you see, output is electrical, hence easy to interface with the AD to D readout. So that means you are getting an analog output, either it may be voltage across the resistance. So if you want to process that analog signal, if you want to give to the microcontroller or a processing device or a microprocessor, that analog signal need to convert into digital form. So that can be easily interfaced to the A to D converter. So the output of the A to D converter can be given to the processor or a controller. It has excellent dynamic characteristics. Accuracy is better than plus or minus 0.1%. It is used in wide range of flow measurement. It can be used in wide range of flow measurement. That is converted into a change in electrical quantity. So this is these are the advantages of anemometer. Disadvantages, if you see, sensitivity change due to dirt or dust on the hot wire. So there will be some dirt or dust in the hot wire. So due to that dust, the sensitivity of a anemometer will change. So if sensitivity changes, means calibrations also changes. That means you will not get an accurate value. Okay, so that is one of the disadvantage. Output is proportional to square root of velocity. Hence, output characteristics are non-linear. So that means, so where velocity of flow. So that means whatever the output you are getting, so is square of the velocity, square root of the velocity. So that means you are not getting a linear waveform. So due to square root of velocity, you are getting nonlinear thing. Slid operation is required. These are the advantages of anemometer. Okay, this is about the hardware anemometer. So coming to the LVDT. So LVDT means a linear variable differential transformer. So before going to this LVDT, you need to know about the basic principle of inductance and transformer. Suppose electrons are moving from left to right, there will be a change in the current. One second. What is strength?
Count guys. Then total roll number guys.
Attendance is called. మీటింగ్ రికార్డ్ అవుతుంది అందుకని నేను తర్వాత లాస్ట్ లో రాను తీసుకుని ఓకే అబౌట్ ద ఎల్విడిటీ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ ఫ్లోయింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ లెఫ్ట్ టు రైట్ So you know the conventional current, a current will flow from right to left. So suppose if you consider a piece of wire, it is wounded like an inductor. So when a current is flowing, so what happens? There will be a magnetic field. There will be magnetic field or flux, we can call as a flux induced in a coil. Okay. So if you consider like two magnets. So when the current is between the two permanent magnets, between the two magnets, electromagnets, any coil is kept. That means any armature is fixed. So if you, when the current is flowing through this current, there will be flux induced in the coil. Okay, these are the two principles of electromagnetic induction. So coming to the transformer, as you know. There are two types of transformer, that is a primary transformer and secondary transformer. So what the primary transformer we will do, so if you see the transformer, in for the transformer you have two coils, this is primary and this is secondary. This is your EI. So when EI is greater than E2, you will getting a secondary voltage. So suppose when EI is some 230 volts, suppose consider your EI equal to 230 volts. So if you consider a step down transformer, so what the step down transformer will be do? It will convert 230 volts to suppose 12 volts. So in that case, we can use this as a step down. That means due to this voltage in the primary, there will be induced or internally developed voltage in the secondary coil. Okay, so this is the principle of electromagnetic in transformer. So due to we applied voltage across the primary, so present in the primary winding. So due to there will be an internally developed voltage will be induced, or we can call it induced or internally developed in the secondary winding. So this is the operation of transformer. So coming to the LVDT, so for the LVDT also you have two transformers. One is primary transformer, and next you have two secondary windings will be there. In the secondary transformer, you have two secondary windings will be there. Those are connected of E2, and between these two primary and secondary, one core will be placed. So that is a magnet, that means a core will be placed, So what you are doing, there will be a handle over here. So when you place the core exactly center at a center between this E1 and E2, we can call this as null position. That means when E1 equal to E2, so you are getting a difference in the voltage. So E0 is nothing but E1 minus E2. You are getting a difference in voltage. So that means at null position, you are getting E1 equal to what? E2 equal to null position. That means E0 equal to what? 0 volt. So this is the potential, difference in the potential at null position. Suppose if you move this armature towards, when you are moving towards top, what happens? E0 as difference in voltage, E1 minus E2 as positive voltage. So when you move this core or armature towards top, you are getting the, that means here what the LVDT will do, it will convert the displacement, the physical quantity displacement, into an electrical quantity. You are getting the output of the electrical quantity as a difference of voltage. That means difference of voltage. That means you are getting E0 as E1 minus E2. Simply it will convert displacement to electrical quantity. So when you move this towards positive side upward, you are getting positive voltage. When you move downwards, so what happens? You are getting a negative voltage. So that means this LVDT will convert a displacement to the voltage. So see here, variable inductance. So that means transducers based on the variable inductance. So inductive electrical transducer, which converts physical motion. So here, what is the physical motion? Displacement. So displacement is the physical motion which changes into some inductance or some electrical signal, either voltage. So these are inductive transducers are mainly used for displacement measurement. Okay. So if you see linear variable differential amplifier, LVDT is a comprises of a coil formed on which three coils wound. So three coils will be there. One is primary coil and two are secondary coils. Primary coil is excited with the AC current. So that means here we have seen in the previous diagram, no? So it is excited with a supply voltage. Secondary coils are wound that ferrite core is, so that is a ferrite core is in between the primary coil and secondary coil. That will be central linear position. Secondary coilings are connected so that okay, see here. So when, as I told you, when the core is at the center, exactly at the center, so that position we call as a null position. You are getting E0 as what? E0 is nothing but E0 1 minus E0 2. You are getting the zero voltage. So that position we call as a null position. So like this, it's moving. So when it is moving towards top, you are getting a positive voltage, and when it is moving towards down or left or right, here he shown left or right, you are getting negative voltage. So like that, here the displacement is converted into a voltage, a change in the voltage, a difference in the voltage. Now suppose here E0 1 is greater than E0 2, you are getting a LVDT positive voltage. When E0 2 is greater than E0 1, that means same as E0 1 is less than E0 2, you are getting a negative voltage. So like this, whatever the displacement is there, top or bottom, displacement physical quantity is converted into an electrical quantity. So you are getting the voltage as a difference of voltage. That means you are getting E0 as E1 minus E2 or E0 1 2. Okay. So this is how the displacement transducer will work. Next one is resistance thermometer. So in the resistance thermometer, so here resistance of metal increases with increase in temperature. That means if you consider, see here, suppose resistance thermometer is there, it can measure the temperature from 800 degrees Celsius to 1100 degrees if you place a conductor between the conductor. So what happens from before R, which is having the resistance R, so this will oppose the flow of current. So that means you are getting a current I1. That means it will flow some, that it will oppose some amount of current, and you are getting the current I1. Here I1 is greater than I, is greater than I1. So in this situation, I is greater than I1. Example, suppose if you so this conductor, what you are doing initially, these atoms will be in the this will collide with each other. This will be in the situation of potential energy. Some electrons will collide, or they will vibrate with each other. Suppose if you are heating this conductor, we are heating this conductor, so what happens, vibration will increase. Here what happens when you heat this conductor, that when you heat this conductor, there will be some vibration will be there. So due to these vibrations, you will get an output as a change in the resistance. You are getting the output as a change in the resistance. See here, the change in the resistance can be calculated by using the Wheatstone bridge. So that means here what happens, we can call this as a resistance thermometer or resistance temperature detector. So that means here the physical quantity heat is there, heat is converting into an electrical quantity, that is a change in the resistance. You are getting physical quantity heat into change in the resistance. So when you heat any conducting material, a metal, so what happens here when you are heating, so initially I1 is greater than I2. So here I1 is greater than I2. So that means if you see here, if you increase the heat, okay, if you increase the heat, what happens to resistance? Resistance will increase. So heat and resistance both are directly proportional. So that means what happens to the current? Current will decrease. So this is how, based on this principle, well, resistance thermometer will work. So see here. So whatever the unknown here, this is our conducting material. This conducting material is heated, and these three are known terms. A, B, C are known terms. So bridge is said to be balanced when I equal to what? Zero. That is null position. So when the bridge is said to be balanced, you can say that A by B equal to C by D. So from this formula, you can find out the unknown term B equal to C into B by A. So that means whatever the heat physical quantity is there, that is turned into an electrical quantity, that is nothing but resistance. Suppose if this resistance will vary, the current in the galvanometer also, it will vary. So you should make this galvanometer to null position. That means current in the galvanometer should be zero by varying this resistance, by varying the rheostat, or varying the resistance, you can make this current in the galvanometer null position. So when it is null position, you can find out the unknown resistance by using this Wheatstone bridge. So this is about the resistometer. So the unknown resistance is there, that is connected to lead wires. This is temperature of hot gas. So whatever the temperature of the hot gas or liquid, that is heat is converted into temperature, resistance. So this is ceramic material. These are the glass metals. So here this is connected to some coils. So whatever the heat there, yes.